So in yesterday's session, we have seen the process of user creation and role assignment, and we just gone through very high level the functional setup manager related, how we can enable the offerings and options, and how we can get to know about more about that offering through respect to predefined documents of information what Oracle provided. Now in the today's session, we'll see how to create the implementation project. Okay, so we have a user called as Cloud ERP, right? Just provide the password. So when you're practicing on this instance, if you have any issues, please email us. If you have some error message or anything, just error message or any issue with instance, please keep in touch with us on this email ID. Okay. So this is the email ID you have to just report that instance related errors or anything. Okay, erpt.com@gmail.com. Fine. So done. So how to navigate to FSM functional setup manager? Just go to setup and maintenance. Click on the username. And within the panel, you can see the task called as setup and maintenance.
One question, Lakshman.
Please.
This is the only way you can come to FSM, or you can also go to Navigator?
So primarily, this would be this. Here also, you can find one task called as setup and maintenance. That can be added also. You can just add. You can add that into any one of the role.
I think
you'll find it. Yeah, here we have that. Okay, the below.
I'm getting the same issue. If you drag on the right side, I'm losing this screen.
Only the solution is you can just minimize it. That's what we have to do the workarounds.
Okay.
Yeah.
Little tricks.
Scroll down. Yeah. Here, just you can see the setup and maintenance. But here are there because of the same task, same role we are getting, application implementation consultant. Because of that, we'll be getting. But, see, it's a big task again, going to Navigator and finding here, searching out of all the privileges what you have. The simple process which you can follow is just so if you want to navigate to Functional Setup Manager, so simple, click on username, then go with the setup and maintenance. Okay, fine. Just select this task, will be landing in the home page. And we have seen these are the different offerings which you called. And if you want to know more about any offering, you can select the high level process flows and if, modules related information. You can find these are the documents which you have already seen. Okay, what information it consists of and features, relevant tasks, etc. And again, we just gone through the process of how to enable, right? And that's the information we have to understand. Now, anyway, this financials offering is enabled in this environment. So now we can go ahead and we can create the implementation project. Okay, we'll see how to create the implementation project. Without creating implementation project, there are specific setups which you cannot complete. Okay, I can say around 60-70% of setups you can complete without project, but rest of okay, the 30-40% of setups you should do from the project only. The reason also we'll be discussing when we work on the relevant configurations. Fine. So once you navigate to Functional Setup Manager homepage, here you can find tab called as Implementation Projects. Just click on this tab. So it will list out all the projects which are created in this environment. You see here, there are many projects for a practice purpose. So the guys are working on this instance for their practice, they created these projects. These are the list of projects which we have in this environment. But if you take the real-time case when you are working for a specific client, just we may create one or two projects. Generally one that you may split into multiple definitions also. You may create project for all the different offerings. If you take example, you are going to implement. So these offerings, for example, financials, HCM, PPM, SCM. For each offering, you can create one project. For four offerings, you can, for each offering one, or else for four offerings only one. Okay, that's how you can create, but so normally we create a single project by including the multiple offerings, which will be used, which will help us when we are going to move the data from one instance to other instances. Okay, so ideally
Lakshman, what is the best Lakshman, what is the best practice speaks
create
one
project. create one project. If you have a case where you are doing the global implementation for the client, in that case, for each country you can create the separate project. Okay, so for India one project, US one project, UK another project, UAE different project. That's how country by country specific projects you can create. But if you are going to do the implementation within one country, the best practice is you can go with one project. Otherwise, for each offering you are going to create the separate project, there is no additional advantage you get. Okay, but when you are trying to move the setups from one instance to other instance, you have to perform the task as a four times activity. Again, there will be dependency failure that will create many issues. That is the reason for one project, for one client, whatever the project you will be doing for a specific country, you can create one project. That would be the best practice. Or else you can, for multiple countries also, you can go with one project. Within that project, country specific configuration can be done. And whether you want to go with the one or multiple, that again will decide, can be decided based on the number of ledgers and business units, how many you are going to have. Based on that also, just for the purpose of configuration, you can take the decision, and which points we have to consider, we'll see in the further discussions, where we have a concept called as a scope selection. There I will talk on that. But normally, just you can take example as just one project would be enough. That would be the best practice. Okay, if you are going to implement these four offerings, or these two offerings, or these three offerings, whatever may be the case, you can go with a only one project.
So Lakshman, you mean that data in each project is not completely isolated from others?
See, when you say project, it is just interface where you can manage the setups. You may have 100 projects, but ultimately the relevant setup configuration data is going to be stored in the same tables. The project can be just here, it will be useful directly to go and access and where you can find the relevant offering within that, and easily you can go and identify the module related configuration. For that purpose we'll be using, I'll create the project and I'll delete the project. Remember, the setups are not going to be deleted, it's the framework you are going to delete, that's all. Okay,
okay,
that's how it works. Fine. So any questions here? Processes. So once you log into the instance, click on the user and select task called as setup and maintenance. It will take us to function setup manager homepage. Then click on implementation project tab, and there you can see all the projects which are created within the same instance. And now to create our own project, what we have to do is you can click on create. Okay, just click on create. So by default system is taking the name. Here we'll give the name as Cloud ERP. Okay, Cloud ERP implementation project. Okay, the same name will be defaulted as a code also. I'll just remove this number. I'll say code as a Cloud ERP. The same system is taken as a description, and the project status by default is not started. Yes, just we are creating the project within the system. Once this is ready, we'll start working accordingly. You can update the status. So by default, what system is doing here is that this project system is assigning to Cloud ERP, the current user from which user we are creating this project. The project will get assigned to the same user. So ideally this should be assigned to project manager. If you want to assign to some other user or employee which are exist in the system, you can click on this drop down option, then go to search. Okay, you can find the user here. Just find the user. There are a few existing users. Okay, you can assign to any one of the users. I want to assign to this user, for example. Assign it. That's how we can assign the project to specific resource. Let's proceed with the same user. ERP cloud.
Lakshman, is there any specific reason why we are assigning to a specific user or a resource?
Just to identify who is heading that project, who is the manager for the project, or who is looking after that project, just for information. That's it. Okay.
But a project is an initiative of an organization, so it cannot be a user.
That has to be managed and controlled by someone. You'll have a manager, right? That's what we are specifying here. Definitely, there is initiative of will be running the many projects. Okay, but for this project, you are working for some consulting company and you identified one client called as XYZ. When you're doing this Oracle Apps implementation to that client, you'll have your team, you'll have a manager, right? So that manager name you can give here, or else if you don't have any manager, somebody will be heading that project. Their name you can give here just for information. That's all. Okay. And you can, by default system will take when you are creating the project that has starting date and the finish date, the tentative schedules, whatever you have to finish the project, that you may provide here, but not mandatory. And because of this, there won't be any control in the system. I may give the finish date as tomorrow, but still I can keep working on that project after tomorrow date also. No control, just for information. That's all. When you talk about project here, just for information, that's it. There are no controls on that. But when it comes to performing the task, there is some role related privileges that we'll be discussing. So system will default some running sequence of project number that you have to override, and code and description it will take, and by default status is not started. You can assign this project to specific resource. By default system will take the current user from which user you are creating the project. Could you please mute from your end? Somebody unmuted, I can hear some noise. When you have some question, you can unmute and you can ask me after the question. So when I'm going to talk about it, you can mute again and again further questions, unmute and you please ask me. Please. Okay, and start date system is taking today's date. Let's further finish here.
Sorry. Lakshman, sorry to interrupt, but I just wanted to get some clarity on this. Tell by me. Doing this particular step, what are you trying to correlate? When, what step in EBS are you trying to correlate it?
You tell me what steps you are trying to correlate. Do you have this concept in EBS? Just for better understanding and discussion, I am asking this question. Could you please tell me what steps you perform in EBS? Do you have this concept in EBS first? We don't.
No.
We don't have this concept. You cannot create the project in the EBS application. Straight away you will start with the configuration. I don't know who is
configuration. Who is talking about the configuration?
One second, please. Who raised this question? I can see two guys are on unmute. Who is Ramesh or Pawan? Please, I could hear a lot of noise. If you have background noise, so that may not work to raise the questions also. So any questions on this? See, the point is here, we don't have this project creation concept in EBS case. So ideally that project related information, you may have separate tools, or as a part of project, the manager may maintain the information saying that, okay, this is our team and this many resources are working and some other role related assignments, etc. And they'll be keep tracking the status in the respective project management tools, or maybe some dashboards or some spreadsheet area. They'll maintain this resource is working for this project, 50% setups are complete, so and so work is pending. But that and all will be doing outside of the instance. But in the Fusion case, you can create the project, you can track all the status related to system related configuration, not more than configuration.
Lakshman, this has been introduced in PeopleSoft almost like 7-8 years back. And ever since, in the initial stages, we used to have a table loading sequence. It used to give, all the dependencies, like whatever we are doing here, the table loading sequence used to have a number of steps. And that used to be the source for filling up the basic functional setups. And in the later point, this has been introduced in PeopleSoft exactly the same way as a project. And you can create it. This is completely, 8-9 years back, they introduced in PeopleSoft.
Okay. But we don't have this sort of definitions in case of EBS. Okay, this fusion they just introduced. We know that many practice, many just futures or some certain logics and approaches they taken from PeopleSoft, JD Edwards, and many other Oracle acquired products. Okay, yeah. This piece could be from that whatever you are referring.
Yeah.
Okay. Fine. Good. Fine. So just this is how you have to specify this information. Then you can just click on next. Don't click on save and open. If you click on save and open, you will have an empty project. Okay, what modules, what offerings and options you want to implement as a part of this project, those you have to include into this. For that, just click on next. Just click on next. Now here you can see what are the different offerings and options are enabled in this environment. Here you can see only the offerings and options within that which are enabled in this environment. As a first step, we have seen how to enable. Here you are able to see compensation management, customer data management, enterprise contacts, financials. If you expand the financials, you'll see different options. These all we are able to see as a part of project creation. The reason is we enabled all these, which are enabled, you can see. Say you just say you did not enable financials. In that case, you don't see financials here now. Okay, that's how it works. So whatever you see here, these all are enabled and available in this instance. Now for as a part of this project, which offerings and options you are going to implement, that you can select. Say we want to implement financials. Just select it. Okay. So just enable that checkbox called as include. Okay. And you say just include, it will take that the product functionality related to GL. Along with the GL, what are the other modules you are going to implement? When you say financial, GL is just very, very much foundation module, right? So supplier invoicing processing, supplier invoice processing, that means accounts payables. Expense means fusion expense as per EBS I expense. This is the fixed assets module. And the customer invoice processing is nothing but account receivables, and revenue management collections means advance collections. Okay, if you enable,
do we need to select each and every offering here, or only the financials?
How to select each and every offering, which modules you are going to implement, those you have to select. Okay, if you select just financials, you'll get only finance, the fundamental, the basic configuration, not module specific configuration you'll be getting. You have to enable.
Okay.
Yeah. And revenue management, separate module. And if you are going to implement intercompany, that you can select it as a part of financials. If you are going to implement budgeting solution, you can enable this. And if you want to just have analytics related to this financial related data, you can enable it. So that some module wise, you can see that profitability related, fixed asset, general ledger, just enable it. And you will go through this information also. Just enable whatever available as a part of financials. Okay. So in the same way, like if you are going to implement any modules from procurement, those also you can just include. So after including, just you have to click on save and open. Then so automatically system will create the task list. Here I selected supplier invoice processing. Whenever I click on save and open project, so to implement accounts payable application, what are the setups we have to perform? All the setups related list it will provide. That would be created by system automatically, since you are including this module or say this option as a part of your project. So any questions here, please? And here, high level, you can
description. So Lakshman, So these are all the licenses which the customer has purchased, or once we enable, once we include these modules, then we get charged per user. So what is this full list, and why are we selecting the specific list?
So for which modules, okay, are just called as offerings, for which offerings and which options we have taken the subscription, okay? So those modules only will be selecting. Ideally, many modules will be available in the instance, but you are not supposed to select them as a part of your implementation. So you may see, like, you subscribed financials, along with that you can see other offerings also, but you have to go and enable only financials that would be available here. You can select and you can create the project. Say you take in the subscription for financials, but by default there are two options: they can restrict or they can allow. But say, for example, you take in the subscription for financials, but you can see many offerings within that instance. You say you are enabling, those would be available for project creation. You will be selecting here, you will be able to do the setups, but you cannot use in the process in case of cloud. In case of EBS, you'll be able to use it, but you'll stuck with the issues, bugs, where your Oracle won't support. That's how it works. Okay. So here you can
see. So you are saying once we purchase the license, everything appears here, right, Lakshman?
Subscription. Cloud case, let's call it as subscription. We are not going to have a license for the product. Subscription will take. Once you take the subscription, already we discussed in the previous session. If you don't mind, can you move from your end? I'm talking about. Yeah, thanks. And here we just discussed the point. Here you'll be able to see, I opened one more tab. You can do that. Here we'll be finding one more value as a subscribed. When you select subscribe, here you'll be able to see what are the modules or offerings you subscribed from Oracle. You are supposed to do those module related configuration only to use in the process, to implement a specific process. Even available, these offerings are available. Even if you go and do the setups, finally you cannot take the advantage of those implementations since you don't have subscription. Oracle is not going to help you on the some patch applications or some related support. Okay.
All means the one we purchased? All means?
All means not purchased, which are available in this environment.
And subscribed is what we purchased, right, exactly. Lakshman?
Yeah, you're right.
The Lakshman, where is the question? Support when it is a SaaS, subscribe, right? Every get upgraded, everybody's latest. So no question of support, right? Anybody can use anything.
Your voice is not clear, and I can hear it's resounding, echoing. Could you please work on it, please? But you can use headphones. That will resolve this sort of issue. So if you are...
Yeah, Lakshman, this is Arvind. I think somebody else also opened up when I was asking a question.
Yeah.
So what I was asking is, these all are SaaS, right? So subscription based. So if anybody uses other options, and where is the question of support? This is SaaS, right? Everybody is on the same platform. Everybody is on the latest, greatest.
Every customer. What one point here? Every customer, they'll have an account with Oracle. That account, they'll be having all the information which customer have subscription for which modules. On that base, they can easily identify and what are the instance they are going to allocate for the customer. Accordingly, they'll just provision within that. Okay, based on the subscription, they can set that privileges. Process should not work. Configuration they will allow, but process wise they'll limit, they'll restrict where they'll stop accessing the other areas of roles to work on the relevant process.
Lakshman, I just wanted to point out, like, this is for the SaaS case. In case of the IaaS, will it be viable?
One second. The whatever we are discussing, that is applicable for SaaS, PaaS, as well as IaaS.
Okay.
Cloud is applicable for cloud.
As well.
Yes.
Okay. if we are having any third party integration into it, will it be viable? Oracle will be giving support for that as well, like some kind of customization if wanted to, we want to do in IaaS.
No, any model IaaS, as we discussed, see, that will give you the flexibility where you can have an installation of some additional product into that environment. That's it. Oracle is not going to support if that platform, whatever the server, just server access space what you taken from Oracle, if you have issues relevant to that, they'll help you. For the product related support, they won't provide.
Lakshman, quick question. Every client will get Vision instance, right, as a complimentary?
Okay. Yeah, partners will be getting. Yep, correct. The not client.
Only partners.
Client, not.
Clients don't.
Client won't get it. If you are a Oracle partner, I mean to say, if you are into consulting and Oracle partner, it can be gold or platinum, whatever. If you have a like cloud practices, you'll get one Vision instance, you may get, but not client. Once client will have a subscription from Oracle, they'll be providing the two instances, one for the purpose of development, other one for the purpose of production. That's it. No Vision instance client will be getting. I'm sorry, there was some network issue. It got disconnected. Okay. Please go ahead with your question.
I think you were mentioning about the Vision instance is available only for partners and not for every client, right?
Yeah, for client, in case of EBS or anything, just it won't be available. But in case of EBS, just, you know, like everything will do on-premise, and we will have a DBA, and where we can, if you want to get Vision, or n number of instances, everything will be in the work of like as a work of DBA. When they are installing that instance, I mean application, they can choose the database as Vision, then that will become Vision database, Vision instance. That possibility we have in
Lakshman, it is breaking.
Voice is breaking. Same with everyone.
It's good to be though.
Okay.
We are good. Good.
Okay. Sometimes there could be issue from the participant side also. Please notice that if there is some issue, please let me know. I'll try to fix it within the best possibility. Okay, so that's like here, when you are getting the instance, you are not going to get any Vision instance from Oracle. Being a client, we'll be getting just two instances, one for development, one for production. That's it. If you are going to use these Fusion applications as a part of on-premise, yes, definitely you can. So you will have an entire infrastructure and all. You will have your own DBA. When DBA is going to install, they can choose the database option as a Vision. And they give in the very simple model of the Vision instance. Now, currently, which you are using the same, the similar environment will get installed where you will have some sample data also. That's how it works.
Got you. Thanks.
Thank you.
This is 11 or 12, Lakshman? Is it 11 instance? How do I know?
Yeah, I'll tell you the process. Any instance, if you want to know the version, just click on the username. So just here we have one hyperlink called as about this page. Just click on this. And here you have another hyperlink called as copyright information. So the version is 11.12. That means this is our 12 which you have to consider. So The series is 11 for Fusion. The actual version is 11.1.12. This is how it should appear. But here the one is missing. Okay, if it is going to be 11 version, 11.1.11. This is what we'll be treating as a version. Okay.
So this is the latest one, right?
Yeah, latest version, yes.
And whether it is a SaaS, PaaS, or IaaS, the look and feel is just like this, the home screen?
Yeah, this would be, you can personalize the look and feel, you can change however you want to see in which color and how the appearance should be.
And can I have tiles here? These financials, SCM, I don't like this, you know, kind of weird it looks. Like how we had in Oracle, one after another, financial, SCM, CRM, can we have that way possible?
Where you are?
One after another? Those colorful things, you know.
Please.
See, unless we put our cursor there, we don't know what that is.
No, you are talking about what? You are talking about these icons?
Correct.
No, see, these are just one time we'll be using. We never use in the business process or configuration part. Okay.
Okay.
So one time you'll just select and it'll go and enable. There won't be any need of knowing which offering and all and coming here every time and placing the cursor to know something else related to that. Just one time. Select it and here there will be a tab called as configure. Click on that, enable, then that would be available. Then you can forget about this all the time. That's it. So it's not related to some configuration or process. It's just enabling so that those will get available. That's all. Fine.
If you want to take out financial from here, what do I do if I don't want financial to be seen in this list? Can we do that?
So these you have to go with the personalizations. With that, you'll be able to disable and the total this list also you can disable from here. For that, you have to create the sandbox. Okay, you have to create the sandbox. You have to enable the sandbox. Then the personalized option will be enabled. Then you'll be able to work on anything. Just you can do that to personalization. Again, different level of personalization. So you have based on that, you can do it. Okay.
Okay.
Fine. So, okay, we'll just continue from here. So now this is a project we created, the project name we given. And within this instance, what are the offerings and options available system is displaying here. And we selected offering called as financials and we selected options within that. And the same for each offering, the offering and options, you can see the very descriptive information, very high level, what it will, it is, what process it is going to support. Okay. So you see that there is no option for cash management also, because when you talk about supplier invoice processing, that means for accounts payables, we'll have a payments that will be integrated and will be supporting the function called as cash management also. Cash management for supplier invoice processing means for payments. So that's how you can just get to know the information by looking into the description. Okay, this you can try maybe when you are just working on the instance. But this is how you can find out. Okay, we selected financial offering. Within that, all the options we selected, now you can click on save and open project. Okay, just click on save and open project. It may take some time because it has to identify all the selected offerings and options. It has to perform the task of generating the task list.
So, Lakshman, is there a defined list of what options we should choose from the while creating this project? I mean, if we miss one of them,
see, it's a simple point. It is very simple. So we should know the scope of the project. See, after any question, my request is please mute immediately, because we get sometimes some participants who are getting some noise. That is the reason I am requesting everyone to follow that process. So just you ask me the question, I'll start answering that. Meantime, you please keep on mute. Again, if you have any cross question, you can unmute and you can raise your point. Let's follow this process on request. Okay. So See, when we are going to just create the project, what options we have to choose, that we should aware of, depending on the project scope, which modules we are going to implement, that we should aware, then based on that only we are going to select these options. Okay, if you say, for example, you implemented financials, later you want to implement some other modules also, in that case, anytime you can add the specific offering or modules into this existing project, that is possible. I'll take you through that. Anyway, we are going to discuss those points. Any other question here, please?
Okay.
Yeah. Fine. Done. Now, here you can see system is taking the status for this project as a not started. Yes, that same we have seen at the time of project creation. Now we can update the status, or you can change this assignment, or you can change the start date, finish date, all this information by just clicking on edit. Just click on edit. So you can change the name of the project. You can now say we started working on the project. Now you can set the status as in progress. The project status is in progress. We started working on the system for the configuration. That is the meaning of that. Then say save and close. Done. So the status is in progress. Now this is a offering we have. Financials we choose. Within that we selected specific options. Now within this offering, you don't see the modules exactly. The module related setup part you can see with the relevant folders. So just expand it. Just drag little right here. You can see the exact names. These folder options, what you see, these you can call as a task lists. This is a task list. These all are the task lists. Here you can see module wise task list also. Okay, define invoicing and payment configuration. It's nothing but with, if you expand this, within that you can find all payables related configuration. This folder, okay, contains all Fusion expense related, nothing but I expense as per EBS, that configuration, and fixed assets configuration, receivables configuration, revenue management configuration, the cash management and banking configuration, and advanced collections. Okay. Intercompany related processing rules, hyperion financial management reporting, which you can integrate with the Fusion financials, and budgeting and financial reporting and budgetary control and the business intelligence reporting. Okay. So this is how just you can see based on the options which you selected, system generated these task lists. Let's go with any one of the module. Say I'm just expanding this, define invoicing and do payment configuration. Just expand this folder. So again, within that we have a subfolders which you call as, again, those are sub task lists. Task list nothing but group of tasks. So define supplier related configuration, supplier creation related, some supporting lookups and etc. You can create, define payables. Okay, define disbursements, payment related, payment system connectivity. If you are going to do with some say EFT and other payments, payment related security, the relevant configuration, you can just look into that. I'm just expanding some of the options. Say let's define payables. Okay, there you can see again some, this you can call as a task, because if you click on this icon, go to task icon, this is go to task icon. One second here, let me drag this. It's not responding. One second. It's not just responding. Fine, we'll see that. Here you can see here go to task. So go to task icon. If you click on that, it will open the relevant function. EBS also we call this menu. I mean functions. We have a functions and we have a submenus. When you just click on submenu, it will open the again another submenu or function. In the same way, here the submenu you may compare with here for this understanding, project related understanding, the submenu you may compare with the task list. And the function you may compare with the specific task. Task and do task list, function and do submenu. So that's how you can compare. So within this task list, we have this task. Again, we have some other task list. If you expand the task list, within that you can find one or multiple tasks which you can perform as a part of definitions. The payment terms is one of the task, and distribution sets you can see as a one of the task. Okay, so just expand this, define general payables options. These are the two tasks which we have, three tasks we have within this. In the same way, define payables configuration. So payables lookups, payables profile option, navigations, and distribution sets, invoice tolerances, aging periods. These are the different tasks which you see in EBS, what we call as function, that here we are calling as a task. So this is what we discuss. System creates task list. This is how it will create based on the option. Since we selected payables into our project, the payables related all list of setups is displaying here, so that you can just go ahead and you can create the specific task. For example, you want to create the distribution set. You have to just click on this, go to task icon. Let me just drag here. It's not responding. I'll just reconnect. I'll refresh this. Oh, that's not. Cloud ERP. So how to go to function setup manager? Just click on setup and maintenance and click on implementation project. The project which is created recently, that will be on the top only. This is a project. To open this, just click on that. So this is a project we created. Expand this financials, expand, define invoicing and payment configuration folder. Just we may expand, just define payments. Within that again we have subtask list. After that, any one of the task list you can expand, you can find the tasks. Now if you want to just create the distribution set, simply you can just click on this, go to task icon. It will open the relevant page. You can define the payment term, the distribution sets. Okay, so this is the distribution sets creation page. You can just click on create, then you can create the distribution set. That's it. So this is how just you can navigate, but you don't need to go with this sort of very lengthy navigations and all. We have a simple option within the project where you can search and you can find out anything. So just keep here. So simply you can search from here. You want to create accounting calendar, which will be part of our ledger. Just search for accounting calendar. Then click on search. Accounting. What's wrong? Accounting calendar. Okay, the task name, everything we call as task. The task name is the task. Manage accounting calendars. So if you want to go with this navigation, this is a path actually you have to follow. First you have to go to financial offering. Within that you have to go to task list called as define common applications configuration for financials. What I'll do is same, I'll open another tab. Go to setup and maintenance. Just click on implementation projects. Open the project. Now see here, if you want to create calendar, first you have to go to financials. Yes, we are in the financials. Then you have to go to define common applications configuration for financials. Okay, define common applications configuration for financials. You have to go to this. Just expand this. Now what is the further navigation? Define enterprise structures for financials. Define enterprise structures for financials. Scroll little down, you can see that. Define enterprise structures for financials. You have to go, just you have to click on this again. Okay, and after that we have a further navigation as a define financial reporting structures. Define financial reporting structures. Scroll a little down. This is a what subtask name, define, expand it, and there you can see the define calendars. Here you see define calendar. Click on that, there will be a task called as manage calendars within that. Now you can click on go to task icon, it will open the calendar creation page where you can create the accounting calendar. So we never follow these navigations when you are working, always we'll go with the just searching and finding in this way. Just I'll whatever I want to create, I can search with the relevant name, it will get displayed. So simply I can click on this, it will open the page. So the same it is displaying, click on go to task icon, it will open the same page. Done. No need to follow the navigations. You don't need to go and search with the different navigations. So simply you can type and you can directly navigate to that. Okay.
Lakshman, yes, yeah. I'm a quick questions. So for navigating the path or go to task, you showed like two different ways. My question is, just my curiosity, do we have some sort of like, you know, shortcut code or table which you plug in on?
We don't have. I think you might be referring SAP there. We have transaction codes. You don't have anything here.
Right.
You don't have anything.
Okay.
This is the best shortcut which you can use. And other option is you can take, if you are using specific task very frequently, you can take into favorites. Okay. In case of EBS, we'll take into top 10 list in that responsibility. We'll just move specific functions into top 10 list. The same way here, specific this page I can just tag to favorites. So next time if I want to come here, I don't need to go and click on this and here and there. I don't need to go with a multiple just process steps process. Simply I can go to the favorites. There I can find out that as a favorite. Here in the list I can find, I can select directly, I can land in that page. This page I can add to favorites. Add favorite. Okay, that's how we can do it. But if you want to perform this, you can search with this exact name. Okay. Fine.
So this Lakshman, yeah. Anybody new to the configurations, do they have any sequence of steps to go one after the other?
Yeah. In a few cases, yes, you can see the sequence. And most of the cases you may not find in the sequence, but you can, system will be addressing over there whether it is mandatory or optional. But when you are doing some limited setups, those you may find in the sequence. But when you are doing the across the modules, definitely that would be difficult to find out. Yes, we have a sequence, but not in all the cases. That anyway we'll be seeing when we start with the system related configuration. Okay.
Lakshman, do we have a chance to export this into Excel sheet?
You have everything on the already expo. You can take into, I just shown that information, right? So the offering or anything relevant, you can take into, you can download the documents, everything you have in that sheets.
Okay. So essentially with the moment we get that the Excel sheet, see all the step by step, right?
Task list and tasks. You can just click on this Excel. For the financials, all will be shown in the Excel sheet. Whatever you see here, those only. You can do that.
So there is no sequence, but are there any dependencies?
Sequence we have, but all the time that may not be correct to do exactly. There could be some other dependency. Okay.
So that's again goes by your experience, right?
Yes.
Okay.
See, and one more point here, system also just will give some certain kind of indication. So here you see the procedure tasks. Here we have one. If there is something, some value or one or two, that means I can understand to create the accounting calendar, there is some other dependency setups. Here it will be addressing. You can click on that, it will display. That's how you can understand that point.
Oh, produces.
That's how it will give some hints. Okay. And one more point.
Yeah.
Sorry.
My second question, and I'm sorry if I'm asking ahead of this question. Let's say, like, you know, today is my first day. I'm a consultant. Arvind is a manager. So I reported to him, and whatever you have doing right now is, he's a manager, he's managing the financials. And that's why he can see all of these, you know, components, right? But let's suppose I'm here as just for accounts payable. Does he have to give me like only that write off, you know, or he has to give me all of these components by default?
We have two options. As a practice of implementation, we will give the full privileges to every consultants where they can have access. Okay, but they know very well what is their responsibility and what they have to do exactly. That is the reason we can give the access to entire project, but they'll be working in the relevant areas to do the just configuration. This is total part is related to configuration, not related to business process. Ideally, we'll be giving access to entire project, but we'll be working on your area only. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, Lakshman, this is Ramesh. If we are considering a fresh implementation, Lakshman, the steps what we do is the multi-org setup. In this process, where does that stand? Is that a first step or performing the subledger configuration? Is that second step?
I'm trying to understand. Yes. Your question is very much valid. I'm taking you through that approach only. If you are going to start working with a fresh instance, what approach we follow, I'm going to take you through the same sequence in our classes. First thing is you can have your own user, or else whatever user Oracle provides, you can go with that. Okay, the next step is we'll create the implementation project. Once implementation project is ready, then you can start, however you just design the solution for the client, accordingly, you'll start doing the configuration. The same approach we are going to follow. Okay, first you have to create the project in the fresh environment. Fine?
Thank you.
Fine. See, this is even a vision instance. I'm not going to use a single piece of definition which is existed. We'll treat it as a fresh, and in case of fresh, how we do that approach we are going to follow. Okay, everything will be creating from scratch. Okay, fine. So I'm searching here as accounting calendar. Once I click on this search, it is displaying some folder. If I expand that, see, just I'm clicking on that. If I click on the task, it is opening some subfolder and all. When I do in this way, if I want to know the navigation, what is the exact navigation to come here, you can click on this hierarchy, show hierarchy. It will show us the exact navigation. If you want to take the navigation to this, okay, manage accounting calendars, what is the navigation you have to follow? So this manage accounting calendars is there within the task list called as defined calendars. How to reach this with the navigation that you can see? Financials, define common application configuration for financials, define enterprise structure for financials, define financial reporting structures. So this is a navigation you have to follow if you want to go with the manual navigation. Okay, this is how you can find out. Fine. Another part here is you can enable the help within the instance. You know, in EBS, okay, in EBS, when you are just working on that instance, EBS instance, okay, we'll be having the help on the top, the question mark you'll be finding, right? In the same way, there by default, the help will be enabled. But here, if you want to use the help, you have to enable the help. Here we have a help at instance level. Show help. If you enable it, then help will be enabled wherever Oracle provided some information to understand specific task or some certain functionality or page. There help will be enabled, then you can just access the relevant data to understand more about that relevant object. So let's see how to enable help. It's a very simple process. So just you can click on this. It will be the, once it's enabled, it will be change the color to orange color here. Let's say just the same, like once you enable here, wherever the help is applicable, that under help it is showing that enable option. That means if you want to know what is the meaning of calendar, you can click on that. It will give you information. What is the meaning of accounting calendar, you can understand. If you disable here, everywhere it will disable. Not only here, in any function, wherever you go, there that same will be applicable. So now see how the help function will work here. Just click on this, that will be enabled. Not only here, wherever you go within this application environment, wherever help related function Oracle provided, there you can use this. So I'll just click on this. So I'll click on this, it will give the very brief description about that task, what purpose the task will be used. So manage accounting calendar, review and do update existing grouping of accounting periods and create new grouping of the periods. Okay, if you want to know more about it, just here for relevant help topics also they given. Calendar validation, how it works with the accounting calendar, define accounting calendar, critical choices. Okay, so that you can take and you can just, if you want to know more about it, you can click on more help. It will take us to completely help portal, which Oracle is providing as a part of Fusion. Let's go, let's navigate to help portal now. Okay. Just wait for a while. So it's up.
While that opens up, Lakshman, in EBS, if we want to associate help using UPKs, we can associate with the help functionality what we have in EBS, like forms. We can go and associate our user productivity kits to that. So if we want to
user productivity kit means what you will be preparing, right?
Correct.
That you will be.
So
Tell me.
Yeah. We can go ahead and associate that in that particular help menu. If we have to do the same way in Fusion, how can we associate that?
No, in the user productivity kit, what is the meaning of associating? See, the instance is a one and the user productivity kit is a different one, right? See, how in that case, what you will do is, so what is the source? When you look at your EBS instance, if you go to that specific module related folder, within that you will have a separate folder called as help, the server point of. Mm-hmm. The folder you can copy and you can take and you can use anywhere. Okay. But here if you want to do it, you can just make a copy and you can take into some other document or any other preparation. That server, everything that control will be having, the folder you can take out, and within that for each page, each function, there will be separate topic, separate file. That file you may associate, that's how you can make use of it. It's going to be cloud and you cannot take that source files of help information, only the processes. You can just go and copy, take that information, you can specify, or else if you are going to use this cloud application as on-premise, definitely you will be able to do it, whatever you can do in case of EBS. Okay, fine. So here, just once you click on this more help, this is how we'll be navigated to help portal. So here you can see this is a home page, and here these are the different modules. Offerings, financials. If you want to go to only financial related help information, you can select financials. In the same way, we have HCM and the procurement and different projects and risk management, different offerings we have. So from here, you can search for anything. Okay, you can search for anything, it will displace the information. And if you want to search only related to financial related information, you want to search financials offering, or say financial module related information, you can select financials. Then system will be able to filter whatever you are trying to search, the very relevant information it will display. Okay, here you can just, I want to search for accounting calendar, just for testing, accounting calendars. If there is some relevant keyword, it will display that you can select, otherwise you can go with a direct search. Yes, there is a keyword called as accounting calendar. Within the search portal, you can click on search. So what are the results we have which are associated with the term called as accounting calendar, it will display. So there are around 8 to 9 items found which consist of this term, and you have a filter options. So you have a help types here, first point. So you can specify whether you want, you are looking for accounting calendar, relevant term related examples. Around 110 examples we have where this accounting calendar term is included. And there are around 988 FAQs are there, which includes this term. And help topics we have 6 to 9. And PDF guides, we don't have anything related to this. In many cases you can see. And the videos, we have a 2 videos which are related to this accounting calendar related term. So if you want to get only, say for example, FAQs, you can uncheck all these options and you can filter for only FAQs, which talks about, which is very much relevant to accounting calendar. Here the all are FAQs. How can I identify errors in my accounting calendar? Okay, what happens if I upgrade my calendar from Oracle EBS Suite to Release 12? So this is the FAQs. It will be applicable whenever the solution is up available. But as of now, we don't have a solution. By looking at this question, don't take another way. Okay, we don't have any solution. They just kept everything based on their future plans and all. The same way, you can see the many questions. What is a payables calendar? Since there's a calendar term, they just included that. How can I change the accounting period name? All these are the FAQs related to your accounting calendar and relevant areas of information. Okay, why can't I close an accounting period? What happens if I change the accounting date? So the users, or sometimes maybe consultants, can use this information to know more about that relevant function. So this is how we have a help type based on the specific term which you search. I'm just trying with the videos. Okay, defining range functions, financial reporting. Since it's just connected with some calendar related, there just the term accounting is identified. That is the reason it is taken here. There will be video related to that financial reporting. So IPRN financial reporting. How the reports can be prepared. They given simple video here.
Tutorial.
Okay. These videos you may find in YouTube also. Oracle uploaded this sort of videos in YouTube also. Okay. So go to search the previous tab. Okay. This is a finance related, all just a home page related to financials. The search results, you can filter the search. Okay, I'm going to again enable all different type of such as help information. Okay, again you can, the accounting calendar you searched. So this term maybe belongs to different products. In that case, you'll be able to filter that help related results based on the product. So you want to know accounting calendar related information which is related to specific module. So only general ledger. Other you don't want to see. As of now you have total 8 to 9, but general ledger related search results only 256. Then you can enable, then say apply. Now it will filter only the search results will display which are related to only GL. That's it. These all are related to GL related. Now within this you can go with help type again, you can filter. Video only 1 we have, PDF no, FAQs only 26 examples. Okay. Some based on the function and relevant areas of functions, they given examples also. Okay, specify ledger options, worked example. Creating primary ledger, example. Create GL balance cubes, example. Okay, accounting cycle, example. All this information, ledger sets, example. Standard balances, example. Okay. So that's how you can just go with the different filter options when I talk about help. I'm just enabling all. I'm just going to uncheck. If I uncheck and say apply, by default it will take for all. Taxation, we have 55 searches related to that. Okay, in the same way, like in the company, the roles, the people, what are the roles they'll be having, the role-specific searches also they can see by searching with some relevant term. Okay, here, finance manager, the relevant information is available as a 251 search results. Okay, financial executive related, 6 results we have out of that, that you can filter, which is very relevant to financial executive related, task related information. The general accounting dashboard where basically the finance executives will be working and the relevant other information and all. Okay, that's how the role wise also will be able to filter. If you uncheck, if you say apply, that is applicable related to all the roles. Okay, the based on the result, the roles also will get displayed. Okay, and language specific specifications also we have, country specific search results also. Okay, these results are very generic and US. If you want to search, if you are searching some information which is related to a specific country, say for example 1099 taxation, when you search, that would be limited to US. That's how just you can go with the specific country specific search results also. If there is some country specific function related information, that would get displayed here. By default, Oracle set default as a generic under US. Okay, that's how the search results you can filter. If something is very specific to country or role or help type or product, okay, and the tasks here. So it's almost, it's related to module. Again, you can just within that module, you know, some relevant data related, you can see some navigations, personally, etc. You can look into that. Okay, so this is how you can just use this help portal. This is home page, you can search directly from here. So irrespective of offering, it will display the results. Okay, here related to, we are in the financial, the related the guides we have. Just click on that, any documents you have, it will show. Quick start guide for expenses, vision expenses. So just kept here PDF, system is loading. And just go through it. Okay, I give in a simple PDF file which talks about the simple process of expense report creation, process approvals, search results, say financials, home page. Same way, videos related to financials. What are the videos we have? Just you can click on this. These are the videos we have. Viewing analytics and reports, creating the journal approval rules, basic financial reports, using application help. Okay, exploring work area and landing page, introduction to invoices landing page, creating an invoice in spreadsheet. For all these, they have videos. But not for everything, for a few. And tables, how you can create the invoice through spreadsheet. The similar ADA, web ADA function they give in the Fusion in many place, many functions.
Hello, my name is Barbara. In this tutorial, I'll show
just
you how
closing this. Okay, so this is how we can take the advantage from this help portal. So you can navigate from anywhere, not only here, just when you are here and when you open this page, there also the same help would be there. You can enable, and wherever help is applicable, that same the help icon will get displayed. You can click on that, very high level brief information will be able to see in the pop-up window. Still, if you want to get more detailed information, you can just click on the relevant objects, I mean to say relevant items. If I click on this accounting calendar, I can just get to know what is the meaning of that, and the relevant items means these I can select. So I just it will open only that relevant information. And again, we are landing in the help portal. Calendar validation. What are the points need to be considered? And below you can see some questions related to that. Okay, when do I update an existing calendar? Naming convention, errors in accounting calendar. how can I identify. So this all you can just get to know by going through this process. Okay, fine. Just you have to just know this information. So that's how you can just navigate and you can enable the help so that it would get enabled. And if you want to open that specific function, you can use this. Okay, done. Now other point here is, just let me come back here. Now see, this project is our project. This project is assigned to our user. Okay, so here also see that since help is enabled, so implementation projects, if you want to know what is implementation project, you can click on that. Gives the summary of that information. Implementation project define the structure of an implementation. They contains task list and task required to implement the functionality you select. Okay, multiple implementation project may exist within the single instance and may be managed one or more implementers. The relevant, what does it mean by task list or task, it's explained. If you click on this link, its implementation project is explained. Monitoring
how do implementation project is explained. Sorry, Lakshman. How to enable this help?
Just click on this help icon.
It is disabled. How?
By default, how disabled. By default, disabled, you see. See, now it's disabled.
Okay.
Click on that. It will enable wherever help is applicable, the same icon.
Okay. Okay.
Fine. So that's how you can do it. Now, see, this project, at the time of this project creation, system taking this name. So when you have multiple projects, all the time you don't need to search for your projects. And just now we created, that is the reason on the top of this list. When you are working for the client and all, you may have one or two projects definition. In that case, whenever you navigate to this page, here itself you can see. Since this is a kind of testing environment, vision instance, people will be creating for their practice many projects. So instead of going and searching for your project every time, what you can do is, so what process you can follow is, after logging to the instance, anyway, you will just click on setup and maintenance, right? After that, click on implementation projects. So here, if you see the big list to find out your projects, it's simple. Click on overview. Whatever the project is associated with this current user, that project will get displayed here. That's it. So we didn't update, do any changes, updates to this project. Otherwise, that progress will get updated here. You can see here, 100% project is not started. Within that, we have 918 tasks. Two tasks are assigned. 916 tasks are unassigned. This is a project progress. This is how this not started, in progress, completed, execution, frozen, and how many days passed you. It's all these assigned tasks by task list and who are the resources are working for the project. So that information you will be able to see from here. So as of now, that the project only one resource, Cloud ERP. We'll just go through that. We'll talk on that points. Okay. Anytime you can add new offerings or any module related functionality into this. So I'm opening the project. So for example, you want to include procurement also into this project. So just click on this search, add. Here you can search for procurement. Search. This is a procurement offering, just that you can add here. Say apply. It will add automatically, will create the task list for procurement also. Click on done. Procurement also added. You can click on expand. Since help is enabled, it is just enabling help for everything. This is a procurement related, configuration related setups. You can expand and you can see detail level. Anyway, we don't need this procurement. Later we'll be adding when you are going to work on P2B cycle, and when you work on O2C, we'll be adding OEM and other modules also which are required. I'm just removing this offering from this project. So after doing the setups by using the specific offering within the project, it's not recommended to remove. There is some reason. We'll work on that once we get into that configuration. That point we'll be discussing. Okay. So now this project we want to, this complete offering, if I want to assign to some resource, okay, manager is cloud ERP, but this consultant is going to be for finance to some different person. Okay, what I'll do is I'll select it, say assign tasks. It would be task, it can be offering or option or task list or task. This would be as a task only. And one more point, say we started working on financials, then you can update the status. Okay, directly you can click on this status icon. It will give the pop-up. You can set the status to in progress. We started working on the financials. Okay, if not from here, you can select the offering and you may click on edit status. The same pop-up window will open. You'll be able to change the status. Okay, you started working. Who is responsible to implement these financials? One second, let it close. Who's the responsible? Just you can select it, then you can just click on assign tasks. That means we are going to assign complete financial offering to specific team member. So click on add. So whom you want to assign? Say there is one user called as cloud. I want to assign to this guy the financials implementation.
Can you do a blind search?
Just it's overlapping.
Can you do a blind search, Lakshman?
Yeah, no. Here you can see this. It's not mandatory, but any one of the field has to be provided. If these all are optional fields where you don't see this double star marks, that indicates it's, you can conduct the blank search. So it's just got overlapped. I'll just refresh. I don't have another option here.
Lakshman, this double asterisk mark tells that this fields are like we can search it, or like we can do the blank search or not?
No. Double, if you have a star mark, we know that field is mandatory. If you see double star mark, right, any one of the field is mandatory. Anyone.
Okay.
Anyone, you have to provide. It's not mandatory. Anyone as a mandatory, you have to provide. Otherwise, you cannot conduct the search results. Somehow it is just hanging.
Lakshman, a question for you. I think two questions. Does all the page, like in EBS, we have who created, last updated by, you know, the username, because I want to know who made the changes.
See,
because currently we have all. Always this problem.
I got it. That we call as who columns, right? Basically, you can go to that certain navigation help there, you can find out. But here, that we don't have. It will get stored in the database, but the view, they are not providing it.
So, record history, we cannot check from the
front end.
So, you have to go back at the table then, right?
From front end, you can. By querying the tables, you can.
Yes. And how about another thing I saw when you, like in the last session, you created a user.
Yes.
Can you delete a user?
Yeah, you can delete it.
Or can you just end it? Because in current EBS,
you can delete. Oh, we have,
but in EBS, options. We have end
it. No. We have two options. We have two options.
Uh-huh.
Just I taken through that information also at the same time, I guess. Just there will be action. Mm-hmm. You can click on that action. There will be three. Options. One is reset password. Okay. Other one, mm-hmm, is delete or inactivate.
Mm-hmm.
You can do that.
Oh, but say suppose that we did a transactions, a miscellaneous transaction in inventory, right? And now I delete the user completely. Okay. Now
the record.
How do I know?
See.
Okay. Record again.
Recording record reference will remain. Okay.
Okay.
It's already stored. It will be done. You know that Rahul will be writing the programming logic where if you delete it has to be deleted, or it reference should remain, or it has to be deleted in this the specific process for functionality, etc. They'll be writing in that process. Definitely that will remain this part where further that definition, the name cannot be acted as a user. Okay, that's how this, they'll look into all these risk elements and they'll have all this.
And Lakshman, all release 12, release 11, table names, columns remains the same?
Yes, yes, yes. Yeah. The no changes. You can take 9 or 10 or 11 or 12. The tables, names and all remains same. No changes. It's a very simple process where you can go and get to know the tables. It's, you see here, I have a link here. Anyway, we'll be working on this. I'll go to this financials, which version, release 12. So finance related, all the tables and views you can find here. It's online information, open source, you can get. This we call as OER, Oracle Enterprise Repository, where you can get all this. These are the tables for financials for the different areas of modules. Advanced collection related, all tables.
These tables are the same as EBS tables or different, Lakshman?
Same as EBS, almost same. Say for example, just for example, I'll take AP AP invoices all. Okay, AP invoice all, AP invoices interfaces, AP invoice distributions all. The same tables. You can click on any one of the table. It shows the information like something, some technical reference kind of information. This AP invoice table, what is the purpose we'll be using, and it belongs to which schema. Schema and owner and
web. How did we come to this page?
I'll take you through that. Just here, right? Just you can search in the Google as Oracle OER, Oracle Enterprise Repository.
Oh, okay.
So you'll be landed. You'll get a first link, and if you click on that, you'll be landing in this home page. You can select relevant offering, and from there you can navigate. We'll be working as a part of our course, so at the time you'll get to know detail level. Okay, just since there was some question to answer that, I'm taking through this, that's all. Okay.
Quick question.
Is there a way to know?
Please go ahead.
Is there a way to know which field, like in Oracle EBS, we were knowing tools, then the table name, we used to get the table name and view name, right? From the front end?
Here you cannot
Is
get
that possible?
Here you cannot get it. See, when you just the same, like when you go to that information, it will be showing which user is created, where the data will be stored in table or view, and who modified, when it
Correct.
Modified, that information, just who columns, that you can get in the EBS case, but here that is not there. That is not there, since the web pages and all, they're just removed.
You don't have concept called about this page, like self-service pages.
About this page, nothing but help only. About this page means help only.
Okay. In our earlier forms, you could go through ADS page and
record history. Record, you mean to say we can check the record history?
Not record history. You don't get it. Pages,
about
ADS.
No. Record history you cannot get for this fusion related any page.
No, what Asbridge is trying to is personalization.
Personalization is
not only personalization. We can see the BOs, EOs, or what are the views tables behind that self-service page, right? So that can be seen here, I believe.
Sorry. I don't know who is talking.
This is Raj. Sorry.
Yeah, Raj.
So what I'm, if we split the about this page in the R12 instance, so it will give us the path and what is the page and for that. What are all the entity objects or view objects used for that? And behind the, what are the tables and columns? So we can see all those things. Right?
Yeah, we can see there, but we cannot see in the fusion case. See here, I'll just say this is our release 12. Anyway, we know that.
Both are ADF pages, right?
Yeah, ADF pages. Just 1 second, just. This is a different browser.
she need to use this Internet Explorer? For the EBS.
Better I'll go with this, not this. Mozilla. That is already installed. So see, the simple point is, however, you could see like information related to specific record, okay, and where that will get stored, who created, who modified, and that information you cannot see in case of Fusion, that you have to get from the back end only.
So Lakshman, sometimes user themselves do the mistakes and they complain later. They complain, I haven't done this and what happened and how. So in case of EBS, we were showing them, last.
You have to go to back end. I'm not saying it won't get tracked. I'm saying it cannot be viewed. Okay, go and query the table. You can find it. I think there's some issue with that. You'll ignore it.
Lakshman, you need to have a Toad. So for Toad, I think you cannot use for SAS, right?
Any model you cannot use. For this, you cannot use. Right, you can't connect to this environments. We have some space where you can go and write the queries. Mm-hmm. You cannot connect any third party tools.
Oh, you have it. Okay.
Yeah, you cannot. The
other gentleman was saying, it's always because I worked in product.
Your voice is breaking.
This is a common thing we need to find, right?
Yeah, sometimes your voice is breaking. I cannot understand. Fine.
Oh.
Let's continue from here. If any other.
Yeah, I'm saying.
Yep. I'm sorry, I'm just muting from my end. Okay. So we cannot understand what you are speaking. It's
okay. Now, what I was saying is, it is important to know the hook, right? So, you can't hear it?
Yeah, I can hear you now, please.
Can you hear him?
Again,
so what I'm saying is, though,
we'll discuss later. Please don't mind because there is some issue. Fine. So we'll continue from here. Okay. Fine. These points we may discuss in the end of the session. So let's proceed with that. The point here is, the direct answer is yes, we don't have that option to see where the specific function related data will get stored and other information. Just give me a second, I'll just reconnect to some other network. Seems so there is some issue with this. Okay, seems to there is some issue with this GoTo meeting, not with the internet connectivity. Okay, the net connectivity we have, everything is working fine, but seems to there is some issue with this GoTo meeting servers. Okay.